The final grade does not depend on the final exam. Most of the time, most of the modules, you can say that really, are evaluated based on 50-50. That means 50% continuous assessment and 50% final exam. So you can see that 100% marks are divided into two, and 50% is evaluated based on your day-to-day performance. So therefore, of course, you must be really careful on it, and then you have to really do well on that. Yes, so then, no matter whatsoever, we have so many advisors, so many professors, so many, no point unless otherwise you move your hands, and then you really do yourself the actions, and it's very important. And importantly, science students particularly means actually all are based on facts and figures, not just you come and say, oh, this is like that and that is like that. No, we always look at clearly, we trust only the facts and figures. You need data and analysis of data to say that, oh, this is correct, or this is wrong, and this is. So then, very important to understand that. Then, further. So basically, you would have also got grades, and then you would have known also, most probably the range of marks belong to a particular grade. Under Gen X, you don't have that. You would have scored most probably 80, and you will still get grade C. From A to F, A is the excellent, and F is the fair, you might still get clearly C. Why? Because all your friends, all your colleagues got above 80. So therefore, you deserve only pass. So then most probably, if you score only 100, you get A. Therefore, I have to say that really, whatever raw marks you get is immaterial. Is immaterial. In the end, we do moderation so that really, based on the performance of all in the class, only grades are decided. Grades are decided. So then, that's also very important. So therefore, I would safely say that, importantly, you better hold on to really the hand given all the time and look at it. What are the laws, rules and regulations? And then please follow them accordingly and don't come and say that I don't know. So that is not the story for university students. So that's why it says ignorance of the law is not a good line of defense. So then today you start reading and try to understand, and then you must follow all the rules and regulations. If you don't understand, you better come and ask. So then, of course, we have, of course, brilliant lectures attached to science lecture. That's where really we are brilliant all the time. So therefore, you better take really the opportunity and then go and ask questions. Usually what happens that I can see that I took lectures. I worked for the last 3 years, less than 5 minutes. Come and ask questions. So then I decided, then everybody should take 100 marks. But then in the end, I see that to be failures. So, please come and really clarify whatever you don't understand. But this you have to do day-to-day basis and not really like your final exam. Right, so then those are very, also very important. University life means it's very, it's a, you are. important. This is no hand tools. Please. During the lecture, no hand tools. I didn't say anything. Yeah. All right. Then I will pass my